Hey guys, Tarek with Cyclone FPV. We're getting ready to do a Caddx Vista repair. And on these Vistas here, they're both showing no OSD. At least that's what the RMA says on it. I'm gonna verify one more time, but it looks stuck in there pretty good. Anyways, so let me go ahead and verify again. It says video works fine, but the RX won't connect to the DJI radio TX. Okay, so the RX is not working. So it's not receiving radio. So let me see, RX will connect to the DJI radio TX, and my goggles OSD shows NA on voltage. Okay, so here we go. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get with this repair here. Let me do a picture in picture. And I've gotta fix this camera up here. I'm not really sure what's going on with it, but it starts wobbling. Somebody's at my house. Hold on, let's see who it is. Nope, they're not at the house anymore. Dang. Can't stay long. Alright, anyways. Sorry for the wavy camera. One of my iPhones here that I use as a camera is kind of screwing up. I'll have another one ready for it, so bear with me. So right now it looks like everything's shaking. It's not. But anyways, so getting to this real quickly, I'm going to go ahead and put the microscope on so you can see what we're going to do. Let me get this ready. STR, let's go there, let's go here, and then let me share that screen with you. So you're going to see this pop up here in just a second. We're going to open the Caddx up here. Okay, all right, now I'm going to unscrew this Caddx and then show you what we're working on. So bear with me 1 second. So right now all I'm doing is I'm unscrewing the Caddx. Okay, sorry. So there we go. Okay. All right, now let's get this under the microscope and show you guys what we need to fix. Okay, so looking at all this goop right here, what we're looking for is this spot right here. Okay? And if you see that, that is in order from top to bottom. It is, these are the diodes. Let me get something small enough to point out. I'll use this tip of this needle. That is the S bus diode, that is the TX diode, and that is the RX diode. STR. Okay, so this is receiving, this is transmitting, and so forth. All right, so what we're going to do is S bus is working fine. We're not going to mess with this one. We are going to take this one, and I believe based on this case, we're going to take both of these out. But for right now, I'm going to go back and review. So give me 1 second here. I want to go back and make sure that his detail is right. You guys are permissive. Video works fine with the RX one. And then my goggles, the OSD does not show voltage. Right, okay. So we're going to take the TX actually. Because the RX won't connect to the radio's TX. But the RX won't connect to the radio TX. The RX, I don't know, that's kind of a little confusing the way it's worded. So what we're going to do first is, let's just do this one step at a time, because I think we're going for the same thing here. But it's going to be a little tricky. So I'm going to show you guys how we're going to do this, and you need to be very careful. I'm using kind of a wider tip, if you can see that. It's a wider tip on the heat gun. So be very careful with that. All right, you can see that right there. Because you can melt the rest of the items off, and you don't want to do that. At the same time, I think that tip is going to be too big. I'm going to need something else. Let me see if I can get a more narrow one real quickly. Of course, I don't have any in my drawer. Don't have any in my drawer. Hey, Jazzy.
Yes.
Do you know where we have heat gun tips? All right, so here's the problem. The reason I said this sucks is because the tips here, when you get small enough, The heat actually just starts kind of pouring out the side of the, like it won't really come out of here as much. Oh, this one's not so bad. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna heat this tip up. You can see it's very thin, okay? It's gonna be very hot in just a minute. We're gonna heat this up. We are going to take some ceramic clamps, which I have somewhere here. Yeah, somewhere. They're not where they're supposed to be. That's pretty, oh, here, we'll take this one. All right, let's take these ceramic clamps. Let's go under the, phone's ringing, guys, sorry. Let's get under here, there we go. Okay, and what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna focus on removing the first diode, which you will see is that one right there. And I'm gonna come in at this angle here, and I'm gonna really raise the heat up here on this air gun here. So give me a second. Okay, let's lower the air itself down. Get the clamp on the diode you want to take off. In this case, it's gonna be that one. And I'm just going to heat it up. And be very careful, guys, because you will lose the other ones if the heat, if the pressure is too high. So you basically just want to be pulling with just enough effort to lift one of them off and not the rest. Raise that up just a little bit. I think the heat's too light. Okay, let's get back down there. Put the ceramic tweezers on here. Aside for a minute, let me just grab these. Trying to do this and keep it on camera is giving me a weird angle, and I can't grip it properly without moving this Vista away from the camera. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually pulling on the diode right now, which is lifting the Vista off the bench by like a few millimeters. When it releases, that Vista will drop back down. go. See? So it released clean, perfectly clean. Diode is in the tweezers right here. You can see that. Okay. Put that aside. That one we're going to let cool off. And we're going to grab the second one. There's the second one coming. Give me a second to open it up. It's a lot different when you're doing this and you have to record it, because the angle you have to hold is a lot harder. Alright, so I'm going to just use the metal tweezers for now. Tweezers, grab a hold of the diode, gently lift up on it, and hold the heat gun right there. Go. It's done. Came off clean. Okay. So now we are done. Both diodes have been removed. Now I'm going to let that one cool off. And we're going to plug this in. See if we can give it a test. All right. Let's move all the screws and stuff out of the way. There we go. And let's grab our, we have a test board here. Can we find it? It should be our test board. Okay, and we should have a test wiring kit. Here we go. We're going to go ahead and we're going to plug this in, and we're going to solder each of the Vistas, and we're going to make sure that we get, I'll pair it up to my goggles, and we're going to make sure that we get all our stuff working properly, all right? Screws in here and put this in place. Glasses on, and away we go. Okay, let me show you what I'm looking at. What I'm looking at is, sorry, this file right here. What I'm trying to see is our wiring gram here. So it's going to be around, this is what I want to see. So let me see if I can zoom in right here. So it's going to go to RX4. So the TX going to RX, RX to TX4. Okay, that's what we needed to see. So let's go ahead and get back to work here. So for testing, I need to make sure I've got this right. So we are going to go to the third in line, is the TX to the RX. It's very strange because the way that they have it printed on here is, I think, different, but it's fine. Let's go ahead and get that done. The wrong tip on my soldering, so it's delaying me a little bit. Let me let that go down and we'll change it out. All right, so we should be able to now grab my radio. We should be able to get the functions working, so let's check it out, shall we? Here we go. Goggles. Is on. Let's get me something to power my goggles on. I'll just use the battery for now. Okay. Binding. There we go. And I'll go ahead and bring the USB so we can see if we have movement. Alright, so we have picture. We can see that. Okay. Now, let's see if we can go into Betaflight. Set this up. Ports. Port 4 would be, there we go. Port 1 is okay. Let's connect. Want to see what I'm working on here. There you go. receiver. Bind our radio. There we go. We've got movement. Radio looks good. Let's go to our configuration. Make sure that we have our OSD on. Save and reboot. And we have our voltage. So now when I go to connect, I go to OSD, and I will just take the, I'll pick something like the battery voltage, and I will drag it all the way up to here. And we have our voltage and everything's running good. If I can show you guys that, it looks, well, you'll have to trust me, I guess, because we haven't. So we have everything on here now. Everything looks good. We have complete interaction with the setup. Yep, and we have our OSD now. Everything's great. And we've got everything working. So there's number one is done. And now we can go ahead and power that off. Go to do the second one. That's burning me. Trying to find the regular tip that I would use here so I don't have such a hard time soldering this together. I took it off and put it down, and now I don't know where I put it. So bear with me a second. Okay, now let's see the next one. Let's turn this on. This one's good to go. It's done. So we can now put in our clip over the UFL. Off. Awesome. There's that one. Works perfect. Let's get the other one to put together. solder it real quickly. Should take no time at all. Okay, red wire, been a red light, so we're good. Let's go ahead and get our goggles ready. Okay, goggles are on, we're gonna bind here in just a second. Okay, do it again. Okay, we got Link there. Plug into Betaflight. You'll just have to trust me on this one because I'm not going to switch screens again. So let's just go to receiver. We have movement. Let's go to here. Let's go ahead and turn our. Okay. Go ahead and get our battery voltage. There it is. I didn't save it last time. I just said okay. So I'm going to click save this time. We have battery voltage and we have everything. So everything's perfect here. So we're disconnecting. We're done. That's it. Wraps it up. Nice work. We have now repaired both of them and they are good to go. Excellent job. Customer's happy, and that'll pretty much do it, guys. So, all right, if you have any questions, let me know. Hit me up at tarek@cyclonefpv.com. Otherwise, guys, God bless, be safe, and most of all, go enjoy your Christmas break, okay? I don't get to see my boys. I'm gonna tell them all, Ashton, Landon, and Jaden. I love y'all very much. I miss y'all more than you can imagine, and I hope y'all have a great Christmas. I will see you on the 28th. But until then, stay in touch because we're gonna be playing some Rainbow Six Siege. Everybody else, God bless, be safe, and go spend time with your family. You never know how much time you have left, so go make the most of it, okay? Talk to you soon, guys. Peace.